Good morning to all my higher class students, right from 6th class onwards to 10th class. The session today, the topic what I'm going to take is something very important and also very useful for your, or I should say it is very beneficial for you. I'll start from scratch level till IIT Foundation standards. The topic here is the concept of quadrilaterals. Before starting that, I'd like to interact with you is you please download this video. These concepts are very useful to construct a quadrilateral. First thing, I'll start from scratch level. I'll complete a different problems occurs in your state book, in your CBSE, ICSE, IGSE, and also other publishers like R.S. Agrawal and R.D. Sharma. So these things are very important. So please kindly focus it. So today's topic is concept of quadrilateral. I'll start with it. Concept of quadrilateral. What do you mean by quadrilaterals? In Telugu you call it as chaturbhujam, in Hindi you call it as chaturbhuj. This quadrilateral, the meaning of quadrilateral, I was always telling you, in especially in mathematics and science, the words actually derived from ancient languages like Greek, Latin and French. This quadrilateral comes from two words, one is quad and another one is lateral. So quad and lateral. Quad means four, lateral means sides. They are called quadrilaterals. Means any figure which has four closed sides, then you call it as quadrilaterals. I'll just draw one quadrilateral and then I'll show you. Example, you can have this, say this. Suppose this is your quadrilateral, okay? You have four closed sides. Say example, this is your A, B, C and D. This is parallel to this. That's all we'll discuss in the in another session. Like today I'm going to give you the basic fundamental concepts of this so that you can do the best. Constructions of quadrilaterals are very important. The construction of quadrilaterals, for that you need to understand the differences between types of quadrilaterals you have. We have six different quadrilaterals: trapezium, rhombus, parallelogram, square, rectangle, kite. So these six different types of quadrilaterals has a few similarities with one or two conditional properties which varies these quadrilaterals from each other. That is what we are going to see here. So first of all, what all the properties you have for quadrilaterals. See, quadrilateral has four sides. One, that is AB. I'll write down the properties of quadrilateral. We have four sides, that is AB, BC, CD and DA. So four sides, AB, BC, CD and DA. These are the four line segments which joins together to form a quadrilateral. So we can write down AB plus BC, CD and DA in that way. Second one, it has four vertices. The point where the two sides join, you call it as vertex. The plural form of vertex is vertices. We have four vertices. Okay, that is AB line and AD line joins at a point, this point, you call it as vertex. So we have four vertices. Second property of quadrilateral is it has four vertices. 4 vertices. What all that? A, B, C, D. And third one. Now you see, you have, suppose if I draw one line from one vertex, right, passing through and reaching to the other vertex, opposite vertex, then this is one triangle and this is one triangle. We know the area of triangle. Area of triangle is 180 degrees. Quadrilateral forms with two triangles, 180, another 180. You get it as 360 degrees. It means the area of quadrilateral should be 360 degrees. It means you have four angles. The four angles you have, that is angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. So it has four angles. It has four angles and you have two diagonals. Suppose if I draw like this, this is one diagonal and this is one diagonal. So you have two diagonals. Two diagonals. These are the properties of a quadrilateral. It has four sides, as I mentioned, AB, BC, CD and DA. It has four vertices, that is A, B, C and D. Third, it has four angles, that is angle A, right? Angle present on A vertex, angle present on B, angle present on C, angle present on D. And it has two diagonals, which starts from one vertex and reaches to the vertex on the opposite side. You have two diagonals. These are the properties of a quadrilateral. Here, the angles may or may not be equal, the sides may or may not be equal, the diagonals may not be equal. These are the conditions which we consider quadrilaterals. Now we'll come to the next topic, you call it as types of quadrilateral. Types of quadrilateral. Types of quadrilateral. As I told you, there are six types of quadrilaterals. We'll start first with trapezium. I'll write down six types of quadrilateral, then I'll, on the next page, I'll go with their drawings and also their properties and how they are little bit different from each other. You should know their properties and you should know their identities so that you can go with construction of it. Construction of quadrilaterals are very important. It starts from class 7 and it goes up to intermediate. I want you to please focus it, download this video so that whenever you want to refer, you can easily get back to it. Types of quadrilateral. Trapezium. Second one is parallelogram. Third one is rhombus. Fourth one is rectangle. Fifth one is square. And sixth one is kite. These are six types of quadrilaterals you find. See, rectangle, square are special cases of parallelogram. How? That I am going to explain. First, we'll go with the trapezium. Trapezium, I'll draw it here. This is your trapezium. Okay. Same properties first you have to write down. But what is the difference between a trapezium and a parallelogram? In a quadrilateral when one of the pair of side is parallel to each other, then that kind of quadrilateral you call it as trapezium. When one of the pair of the sides is parallel to each other, then you call it as trapezium. So here the same properties, this is your A, this is your B, this is your C, and this is your D. You have a common properties like four sides, four angles, four vertices, and if you draw two lines, the you call it as diagonal. So you have two diagonals. These are the common properties what a quadrilateral have. Apart from that, trapezium means one of the pair is parallel to each other. That kind of figure, that kind of quadrilateral, you call it as trapezium. Now you see, this is parallel to this. Right, this is parallel to this. This side is parallel to this side. These sides are not parallel to each other. When you extend this line further, when you extend this line, both lines are going to intersect at a point. That's why you call it these two lines are not parallel, but these pair of one side are parallel to each other. So such kind of quadrilateral you call it as trapezium. You understood? I'll give the definitions also later. Now I'll go to parallelogram. I'll just tell you the difference between parallelogram and trapezium. Suppose if I take this is your parallelogram. Example, here you have the same property of what quadrilateral have, that is you have four sides A, B, C, D, and you have four vertices, okay, and you have two diagonals if you draw. Then what is the difference between a trapezium and a parallelogram? This is your trapezium. Parallelogram, see, we have two pairs sides of parallel lines. Okay, this is parallel to this, and this is parallel to this. So two sets of parallel lines forms a parallelogram. One set of parallel line form trapezium. So that is the difference between trapezium and parallelogram. You understood? Rectangle, square, they are all special cases of a parallelogram. You can say a rectangle is a parallelogram, but a little more conditional properties you have there. When the angles are exactly at 90 degrees, then you call it as a rectangle. So in that way you have a little more conditional properties to differentiate between parallelogram and rectangle. That's why we call it as rectangle, square, or all special cases of parallelogram. So you can say square is also a parallelogram, you can say rectangle is also a parallelogram, because you have only one or two properties, conditional properties more to differentiate between these things. But whereas these two are different. You understood? All trapezium can be a parallelogram, but all parallelogram cannot be a trapezium, because it has one set pair of parallel sides. So parallelogram, all parallelograms can be a trapezium? No. You can see here you have two sets of parallelogram. That's why these kind of conditions I am going to explain, and I am going to explain even the construction, what all the informations you should have. There are five different types of informations you should have to construct a perfect quadrilateral. What all those? Example, I'll tell you. Example, you have conditions S, 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 A, S, 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 D, D. These kind of informations you required to construct a parallelogram. Suppose this, you have four sides and one angle. Similarly, you have three sides and two diagonals. In that way, you should have at least five types of information so that you can construct a perfect quadrilateral. So in this way, I'm going to start, and I'm going to tell you, first of all, after finishing the basics, I'm going to state textbook. We are going to do the problems there, constructions. Then afterwards, I'll go to CBSE, ICSE, all different problems. I'll go with other publishers like R.D. Sharma and R.S. Agrawal for IIT Foundation Standard. Okay, shall we start now? The next topic here is rectangle.